response of celery cultivars to the root knot nematode Meloidogynia incognita. The root knot nematode Meloidogynia incognita cheatwood is one of the most important pathogens of vegetables worldwide. Two commercial cultivars of celery were evaluated under greenhouse conditions for resistance to Meloidogynia incognita. Inoculation of 1,500 eggs per plant significantly affected the growth and yield of the two celery cultivars 8 and 16 weeks after inoculation. A significant interaction was observed between treatment and cultivar during the two assessment periods. Apparently, the effect of root knot nematode to celery cultivars becomes more detrimental with increasing time. This can be observed in the significant reduction of yield, plant height, and root weight of these two cultivars 16 weeks after inoculation compared to 8 weeks after the inoculation. Similarly, the number of gulls, egg masses, juveniles, and egg-laying females inside the roots and those that were recovered in the soil increased over time. Significant differences were noted in the number of gulls and egg masses between the cultivars tested in both assessment periods. Root knot nematodes are sedentary endoparasitic roundworms that cause serious damage to crops around the world. These nematodes are common to celery production areas, which can influence yield if not managed properly. Damage to the root system reduces growth and consequently affects its capacity to take up nutrients and water from the soil, resulting to stunting of plants or death. Yield losses in celery production areas can reach 10% in severe infestation levels. Plants infected with nematodes are also predisposed to other diseases through the wounds created in the root cells. In the Philippines, screening of some vegetable varieties for resistance to root knot nematodes has been done by nematologists from the University of the Philippines at Los Baños, but few reports have been published on the association and damage of root knot nematodes on celery, including other plant parasitic nematodes associated to this crop in other countries. In view of the damage caused by root knot nematodes to celery, there is a need to evaluate the susceptibility of existing commercially grown celery cultivars for these nematodes and their effect over time. The use of resistant cultivars is by far the most economical way of managing plant parasitic nematodes in vegetables. Plant and nematode material. Seeds of celery cultivars which are being cultivated for commercial production in the Philippines were pre-germinated in seeding trays containing sterile soil in the greenhouse. The seedlings, about 2 to 3 weeks after sowing, were transplanted into 8 cm diameter pots containing sterilized soil, sand, and processed chicken manure. Inoculation of Meloidogynia incognita in celery cultivars. Gall roots were collected from single egg mass culture plants and washed under flowing tap water to remove adhering soil particles. These gall roots containing egg masses of Meloidogynia incognita were chopped into 1 to 2 cm pieces and placed in 250 ml flasks. Eggs were allowed to disperse from the egg mass by dissolving the gelatinous matrix using 1% commercial bleach in this flask by vigorous shaking. Nematode in columns were standardized by determining the number of eggs in a known volume. The number of eggs in a 1 mm alicut was counted under a stereo microscope and multiplied by the total volume of the suspension. About 1,500 eggs were used for inoculation per plant into 4-5 cm deep holes made near the root zone of the plant. When screening for resistance, the amount of nematode inoculum should be enough to establish the population, but limited so as